the first of the drivers away. The second of the drivers. This is the California. He's just got to climb into the car. Here's Ken Block making his Rally GB debut. The energy drink and probably stalls it. He goes, need more energy drink, Larry. So on to the next of the drivers that's going to be flagged away. It's the Sheikh Khaled Al-Qassami is one of the government ministers. Matt Osberg, in one earlier, he's going to want to try and get into the top six in next up, gets over the on his own, the 2007. And I think that that is Councillor Hyde. Job done for that. You can get back in the one now, Councillor Hyde. Thanks very much for doing that. And about the destiny of Danny Sordo for next season. Next up, we've got probably one. Chris Patterson in the co-driver's seat. Four Rally GB wins. Looking for win number five. Can he do it this weekend? Stopping him is the Finnish driver, Jari Matti, on Rally GB and looking to clinch that second in the championship. Next up, Sebastian Ogier, if anybody can, Seb Ogier here, Julian Gracia away down to the start area, making it spectacularly big victories, and the number one car then makes its way back to the start area. So that just about does complete the various formalities down here, David, so the drivers and the cars are going to head back down to the start area. It's lighted up, the forward focus, and it's a two, and then the car skips its way through the mid part of the stage, so the Ford Focus so far so good, doing everything absolutely right, keeping out of trouble and looking pretty quick, pretty tidy, but not overdoing it.
Yeah, absolutely. What you've got to remember as well is whilst they have wrecked this stage, they've only done it at 30 miles an hour. Now, he was approaching that that jump considerably more than 30 miles an hour. Now, he's got to determine then exactly where he stands for that long sweeping left-hander there after. He's into the back part of the stage now. We can see the floodlights come back in towards us, into this right-hander, which leads them back through the gateway and back into the arena area.
You're looking tidy, David. I was going to say it's a bit sideways, but it was properly done. In the Monster Energy Drink car, and the stage getting more and more slippery, of course, as the rain continues to fall. That's going to be a bigger problem for the later runners, isn't it? Because they're going to have even more puddles and a bit less traction to worry about. So here comes the American. Ken Block heads up towards the young lord. The followers spin up. That's the car accelerates its way through the stage.
Monster Energy Drink. And if anything, you're quite right, David. I think he is looking a little bit quicker.
The time to beat is a 1 minute 23.7. Chazon was able to do, and I think he's going to be a fast RC, the S12, the older car, the 23-year-old Norwegian then, who has been a double Norwegian champion. In fact, in 2007, as the Subaru comes towards us, 2007, the year that Mats Osberg won the championship, he won every event, all seven rounds he won. Here comes the Subaru, over the other, and he lands pretty well, accelerates through the stage, this does look pretty good, so it's okay, he doesn't look compared to Al-Qassimi, I'm still thinking out of drama. Well, Al-Qassimi was second, he did a 123.4, 3 tenths quicker than Cam. He's looking good. Up to the up, and let's just look at him going through the up, all quick, all neat, all tight, lines, a much tighter line towards the completion of the loop, then into the arena, and up towards the completion of the stage, and we'll see where this time puts him relative to the other three. Looks a bit wide there from Kimi, flicks it back into five. And to this stage, of course,
puts in the forest on the gravel, as well as heading Solberg then comes through that distance.
Big cross move to rally in the mid-1990s. Now, Kimi Räikkönen is quickest so far. The time is through. It's a 1:19.4. So Kimi Räikkönen is on it. It's going to be Matt Wilson in number five. Now, over the up through the arena in the UK Championship. Now, let's just see whether we've got a time yet for Adam Solberg, who has gone through. Here comes. Turns his way back to do that. He needs to do that. Just give me as Mikko Focus, winner of the opening round of the championship. Since then, he was on the podium as third place driver in Turkey, and he's had a few falls from it. He comes back through the arena now. A fall as the next round.
I think on
Distasio Riley, 117.3. He's absolutely Sebastian Loeb to be world champion, and that's a long, long time ago, back in 2003. He won Rally GB in 2002. Here he is, back in the accelerating his way up towards. That would be a very, very popular victory here at Rally GB. And he goes second fastest, does Hollywood. He split, therefore, doesn't he? Sordo and Raikkonen. So Danny Sordo, the fastest. Is the margin between Sordo and Sweden, podium in Jordan and in Japan as well. So Gary Mattilatvala is certainly a driver that's going to be out there over the course of the next 3 days. Vala to come in. Here's Ogier. Sebastian Ogier through the stage. Here, back into view comes Sebastian Ogier. It's looked pretty good so far tonight, hasn't it? Then back into the arena. So we'll worry about this year's World Rally Champion. We'll see in a moment what a Sebastian Ogier time is going to be, but it's not there yet. And Sebastian Loeb is the man that could end the night top. And he comes very, very quickly into the arena. Launches himself over the end of WM history. Here he comes. He gets it into the right hand of the Citroën C4 of the 7 times World Rally Champion, back into the arena. Sebastian Ogier, he has now gone quick into line two as we got to the first of the production car, brother, that's the Super 600. This stage now is Xavier Pons. My thanks to David Addison. He's got a pretty long trip back up to North Wales. He'll be back up at Sweetland first thing in the morning.